Good evening. Welcome to Spa Brunch, our special series where we're at the Golden Door Spa in Escondido, California, Fireside Chat Series. Today is our second day of our week-long program of pampering and hard work, let me tell you, here, and we are so glad you joined us. I'm Candy, your host. I want you to just get cozy, grab a cup of your favorite tea, blanket, and just sit down and have a little virtual spa break with me. Also, be sure and pop on by artofthespa.com, where I'll be adding extra details about the visit and more specific product recommendations and ideas for you to bring this experience that I'm having right into your very own home. And on Facebook, we also invite you to spa along with us. Every day, I'm posing a certain question or a dilemma here at the spa of the choices that I have to face, and we just love your input. You might recall today's question was whether or not for me to take the hula hoop dance class or the Be Happy and Thrive class. Hula won hands down, and I want to thank all of our friends on Twitter and Facebook who chimed in and helped seal the deal on that one. It was really fun, and I'm going to tell you all about it in just a little bit here. Today, I had a spa epiphany, I guess you might call it. It's sort of what I call the gifts of the golden door. It just seems everywhere I turn, there are just random, interesting, fun, unique, personalized things that almost like gifts that just sort of fall from the sky. And I just can't tell you, it just makes every day more and more interesting. And it's just given so many great ideas. I can't wait to try some of these out at home myself. But one of the biggest things I have to say is friendship. All of the ladies here are so interesting and inspiring. A lot of them have their own businesses. They're full of vim and vigor and passion, and it just inspires me so much and really rubs off getting little nuggets of wisdom from them. And one of my friends that I've made actually is leaving tomorrow, and I'm so sad. I can't believe she's already, you know, taking off. It seems like the week is going to start speeding up very quickly here. Even at dinner tonight, our table was we were laughing about how tired we all were yesterday and how hard, you know, it can really be to let the outside world and things go and really just get into the experience here. And one woman who has her own business, I was telling her about mine and that I was, you know, it's been a really busy year, and it's been really tiring and great and tiring, but nonetheless. And she gave me a really great piece of advice, which is, you know, that we just, at one point when everybody's like that when they first start up a business. So if you're in the same boat and starting up a business and you're just feeling really tired and feel like, oh my gosh, it's just all too much, you know, to take heart in her advice. I thought it was just really, really awesome that we just can't do it all. And at some point you have to just get somebody to help you, either as a partner or hire someone, even just part-time, or get an intern. And we were joking about the food. The food is just awesome here. Some people, though, if they're on like a weight loss plan, they get a smaller portion than the other guests. It just depends on whatever your personal goals are. So we're all eating the same amazing food, but just different amounts. And they were all laughing because they were just sort of comparing their sizes, and, you know, it's really just so much fun. I mean, it's like Girl Scout camp almost, but better, you know, Girl Scout camp with, you know, luxury gourmet food and accommodations and scenery. And another gift I found today, where they have these in the Wisteria Lounge, which is where we all meet in the morning before our morning hike, they have they're little like signs that you can tie onto your arm with yarn. And they say, you know, I do not wish to be spoken to until I remove this sign. And I thought that is just the coolest thing, because how many times have you been at home and you're just like in a really bad mood and you want no one to talk to you? You're just like, oh, leave me alone. Should I leave me alone? Well, why not? Make one of these little signs. Wear it. You know, to have a little family meeting. Tell everyone, you know, when mom's got this sign on, then, you know, leave me alone. And I could see where it would be really good, too, with especially if kids, when they get in bad moods, you know, how they can be snipey, and have them put it on, and so they can't be spoken to and that they can't speak as well. And it was just a little sign, just in a little basket in the lounge. And it was just such a cool, I thought, a really innovative idea. And it's just such a non-confrontational way to really, you know, just get across, you know, I just need my quiet time. And little things like that, they just keep popping up everywhere. And then when I came back from dinner last night, I had a little vial of hand lotion and foot cream on my pillow. And then tonight, when I got back, I had some geranium fragrance oil on my pillow to try out. And I mean, wouldn't that just be awesome to come home to that? You know, when you come home at night, have just like a little gift or a little something, even a flower waiting on your pillow. And you could even seriously plan it when you leave for the day. You could just like stick a little something there just to make you feel good when you're going to bed, just a little special something, your favorite room spray, or you know, something you can use right before you go to bed, maybe a music CD. But it would just really remind you to take that downtime and kind of get into the relaxation mode and have a really good deep night's sleep. So seriously, it's really like Christmas here every day. So kind of appropriate to the season, and I can't wait to see what we're going to find tomorrow. But getting back to today was really about fitness, I have to say. I'm sort of starting to get a sense of how the rhythm of things are working. Like yesterday, I was really tired. After, even though I didn't do that much activity, did two fitness classes and then had, you know, my massage, and which I was so sore this morning from, by the way. I had a trigger point massage yesterday, and I think I told you it was one of the best massages I've ever had. And this morning I was sore from where my knots were, the toxins were released. So that was really surprising. But, you know, it's a good kind of sore. And I can't wait to kind of feel what it feels like once this wears off. And my massage therapist today, she actually made a really good point. If you need an excuse to get a massage, especially if you're trying to maybe lose some weight or just relax, they say the massages here are actually not a luxury, but they're a necessity. Because, I mean, not only do they increase your metabolism, but they actually loosen up your muscles and your joints and make it easier for you to train harder. And I have to say, I'm a little bit worried because this morning, my very first thing I did this morning, woke up, my breakfast arrived at 7:30. We have breakfast in our room. So, and I actually have mine in bed, so don't tell anybody. But I feel like just like a princess having my breakfast on my bed tray in bed. And then I really didn't want to get out. I was like, oh, but I had an 8:15 appointment with my personal trainer this morning. So you meet with your personal trainer like about four times when you're here, and they put together a program for you to take home. And he had promised me that he would do some rhythmic work to kind of take the boredom out of weightlifting for me. And he was right. He definitely did it. I went over to the gym, and he had these things called kettlebells. And they're really interesting. They're almost like a cannonball with a handle. And then they have all different weights and sizes. And you just take those and you do different arm exercises. But he totally mixed it up. Like, we put really fun music on. And then we did almost like a dance routine. So I was doing different steps with my feet while at the same time I was doing my arm work. And it just flew by. I couldn't believe the 45 minutes just totally flew by. We used that, and we also used the medicine ball, worked on a lot of twisting, and he's going to be writing down the exercises he showed me, and I'll be sharing some of those with you later on in the week, too. And really, I didn't even think I was that winded, but he promised me, you know, that tomorrow, he said tomorrow is going to be a lot harder. He said he went easy on me today just to kind of introduced me to the exercises. So, I mean, I don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. I may be talking to you with, you know, from bed with Bengay all over me, who knows? But it's definitely a good thing for sure, as Martha would say. So after my fitness class, he suggested that I go to, after my training with him, and Nick, my trainer, suggested that I go to yoga. I hadn't been to any of the yoga classes here yet, so I thought I'd give it a go, and I'm so glad I did. It is, first of all, what kind of keeps you motivated and helps you be able to really do more than one fitness class a day here is that they have like 7 different gyms, and they all are bright and sunny. I mean, I can't tell you what a difference that makes when you have somewhere to work out that's really beautiful, has a great view. They all have views of the Japanese gardens and the fragrant, you know, rosemary and herbs just comes wafting through while you're working out, and it just really gives you like a high. It's really, really wonderful. And the yoga studio is up on like a little hill, so you have to walk away from like where the weights and those kind of gyms are, and you walk up to this other gym, and it is up. It almost looks sort of like a pagoda kind of building, and it's up on a little hill. And the whole front of it is glass. So it's nestled into the hillside. The whole front is just glass, beautiful. And you go inside, and it's got this like super uber cushy carpeting. It's kind of really almost challenging to do yoga on, but it sort of adds a little balance element in there. But so soft. And they had your yoga mats, and just everything was just like amazing to touch and to use and to look at. It was really beautiful. And I think that really makes a difference for me. And it's just such an honor to be able to work out in a place like that. So, you know, doing yoga there, especially when we're doing our poses, today's focus of the class was balance poses. So we're doing our poses, and you can focus out onto the gardens. It's just really surreal. And the teacher was so phenomenal. Like all of the staff here, I mean, they really are on their A game. I've never had such a great variety of like things to do, but where everybody who is involved in teaching you and helping you with it are so well versed in what they're doing and all the latest things. And our teacher, she was just so fun too, which sometimes you don't really have with yoga. And, you know, she was talking about, you know, balance and life and balance and the poses and how that sort of, you know, you can kind of think about, yeah, you know, try to balance your body physically and think about that emotionally too. And then we were getting in and out of some kind of tricky poses, and she was like, oh, you know, just like in life, things are easier to get into than they are to get out of sometimes. You know, she was that, you know, like relationships, for instance. So, and that was really just a fun touch. And I can't wait to have another class with her tomorrow. So, and that, but that doesn't stop there. I'm telling you, it was definitely fitness bonanza today. After that, I went to a boxing class. And we even had, they wrapped our wrists all up, which was really it felt kind of weird at first. I wasn't sure I liked it because, you know, you couldn't really move your hand, but they wrapped them up really tight with tape, just like boxers. And then they put boxing gloves on us, and they had the, the big bags hanging from the ceiling. And then they also had a speed bag. So, and there were 12 stations in all. And I was thinking, you know, this is going to be easy because it was only like a 1 minute each of the 12 stations. And I was thinking, oh, this might be kind of easy. I don't know, but it was killer. I mean, you had to, because what they, you know, really wanted you to just like give it your all at each station for a minute. And, well, I don't know. It was really fun. I love those bags, the great big bags. I've done kickboxing, but I've never like hit the bags. Boy, and so when you really hit those with all your power, it is just so much fun. It gets rid of a lot of stress. And you can get versions of those that you could have, like even in your home gym. It'd be fun for your kids. They have, I think Everlast has even like just blow up ones for, you know, just for fun. So that was really amazing. I was like dripping after that. And after that, thank goodness, I had time for a break, an herbal wrap, which was perfect because it really loosened up the muscles. But, you know, if you're having a big, hard workout day, you don't have to do that. You know, you can go sit in the steam room or sauna, but they have these herbal wraps here where they soak the sheets in rosemary water, which is really good for your circulation. And then they wrap you in those, and you just have like a really good old-fashioned kind of sweat kind of thing. It almost reminds me sort of like, you know, the old school sweat boxes. Have you ever seen those in a movie? Like somebody goes in there and then they get, you know, they sweat and they get their pores clean and everything. So I thought that was a super, super touch. So thank goodness that was bad. And then it was lunchtime and I was really hungry. So, and I actually took a picture of our lunch today. They were tofu spring rolls with some salad and a cookie. I tell you that you are not deprived here at all. So I'll be posting those on artofthespa.com, the pictures of those. So you can have a look and see what you think, if it's your idea of spa food or not. And I can tell you right now, though, you won't believe it. It's just, and everything is beautiful the way they present it. Chef and their staff are just doing an amazing job with that. But in my active day today, it didn't end there. It was after my massage this afternoon. There was one other class that I wanted to try, which was the hula hoop dance class. I don't know if you've seen this, but it's kind of a new trend. And they have hula hoops, but they're weighted. So they have like a little bit of weight in them, and you can spin them around your waist, and it's easier to hold up because of the weight in the hoops, and the size are like bigger than kids' hula hoops. And it was so much fun. It was just really just like freeing. It was just, you know, not a hard workout. It was more just free flowy, dancey. We like spun the hoops around our waist and we walked, we like did turns with them. You should have seen the teacher. She was so cool. She looked like, I don't know, like a little rubber doll bending and twisting, and the hula hoop was going up and down her body like it was just nothing. And it was almost as fun to watch as it was to do. So I'd highly recommend you can check out, they've got DVDs for that hula hoop dancing, or just go online and do a search. And I'll put up some resources for you too over on artofthespa.com. So as you can tell, today was a fitness focus, definitely a focus on exercise. But what was really neat is that I didn't really feel that it was, because we were in like so many different environments doing everything. And, you know, and it really, everything was a mind-body kind of thing. All of the instructors like really, you know, tie things back to your normal everyday life outside of the spa. So, you know, you can really use that when you get back. So if you have any questions, or you know, are interested in what other kinds of workout classes they have here, you know, drop me a line, candace@artofthespa.com, or, you know, put a question on our Facebook page, Art of the Spa on Facebook. I'd be more than happy to let you know about some of the other cool classes and things they do here. And, you know, if you're at home and you're thinking, oh my gosh, I could never do anything like this, you know, it doesn't have to be this big, you know, an hour of the classes. I mean, the training I did today, Nick said that's something that, you know, when you're at home, you do that like 3 times a week. It only took like 25 minutes. You could do like a 20 minutes of a yoga DVD after that to like stretch out all the muscles you just pumped up. And then, you know, you could do any kind of fun aerobics DVD or dancing DVD, or go to a class. I mean, totally mix it up. You don't have to belong to a gym. You can really, really, you know, get, it wouldn't be, of course, you know, as quick of an effective I don't want to say weight loss, but, you know, it wouldn't be as fast without doing as much as we've done here. But when you make it fun and you're playing and you're inserting just a little bit of this into your everyday, then you don't need to worry about doing it, you know, doing 4 different hour-long classes a day. You'll get lots of great results and feel really great and have a lot of fun. So that's what we're always all about here. And there's one other thing I wanted to share with you before we go for the evening. Another fitness component that you can do that is something they do here called the 10,000 step challenge. And I don't know if you know this, I surely didn't, but if you, they've done studies that show that a woman that takes more than 10,000 steps a day is fitter and healthier and will, you know, maintain that health than someone who takes less than 10,000 steps a day. I mean, not like on the border, not like 9,999 steps. I mean, you're still pretty good. But, you know, you should strive for 10,000 steps a day to maintain your health. And if you want to lose weight, then you need to go for like 12,000 steps a day or 15,000 steps a day. So, you know, and that's a really easy thing to kind of to try and do. This could be part of your New Year's resolution, kind of from the golden door to you. Take this challenge. I think it's such a cool thing. I'm going to do it when I go home. And all you have to do is just buy a pedometer. You can find them pretty cheaply at any sporting goods store. You don't need a fancy one, just one that, you know, counts every step. And you wake up in the morning before you hop out of bed, set it to zero, and just attach it to yourself, and then just go about your day. At the end of the day, when you're going to bed, take it off, see how many steps you took, and record it. And, you know, if you're below, then, you know, just start thinking about some fun ways that you can add some more, we'll call it steps to fitness, I think is an appropriate name. Into your life, you know, maybe just park a little farther away from the mall or take the stairs at work and maybe do a few more things around. Like maybe if you're on the phone, just walk around your house, just little things that you can do. So you can do it. I know you can. And before we go tonight, our focus on fitness day here at Golden Door Spa, I wanted to tell you just probably the most incredulous thing ever. We had for dinner, get ready, macaroni and cheese. Seriously, at a spa, we had macaroni and cheese, and it was really good. It was wheat pasta. So good. So good. Nobody could believe it. Everyone was like drooling because when it came out and they put it in front of me, all the girls at my table with me were like looking at it and saying, why didn't we order that? They actually liked it so much. They asked the kitchen to bring out a little bit for them to have with their meals. And they did. So see, you're not going to starve here. You're going to be well, well taken care of. And so that's all for tonight. We'll be back tomorrow, 9:30 p.m. Pacific. If you got something you want to talk about till then, tweet at me, Art of the Spa on Twitter. You can tweet at Golden Door too, at Golden Door Spa. They're on Twitter. They're on Facebook, Golden Door Spas. We are also on Facebook as well, like I said, Art of the Spa. So just fire away. We're waiting to hear from you, and we hope that you're enjoying our stay out here as much as we are, and looking forward to talking to you tomorrow. Sweet dreams. Have a great night.